What was once lush green farmland is now a lake. There were chicken farms here, but only the roofs are visible. The waters turned John Glasma's home into an island. Good thing he has a helicopter.
We had to bring farmers in to rescue their cows. We've had to bring cancer medication over because nobody could get over to the Chilliwack side. Everybody's been doing their part.
It's true on the ground, too. Working around the clock, trucks lug rocks and soil from the quarry to the Sumas Dyke. They line the road outside Shane Anderson's house.
It's unreal. It's amazing how much stuff they have to put to shore up the levee.
Work on the dike, the only barrier between the Sumas River and the land, continues ahead of Tuesday's rain. In this waterlogged zone, there is nowhere for it to go, and every millimeter counts. But the floodgates are now fully open, and the Barrowtown station is pumping water into the Fraser River and away from the flood zone.
With all this good news, we are still a long way from being out of danger.
Some of the danger is obvious. Some of it is not.
So stepping off the edge of the asphalt here and thinking you can walk into the farm field, that's a pretty deep drop.
These waters have washed away entire seasons. Cabbages and peppers float with the current. At the end of this road, Narinder Bengal's farm.
I just come here every day, sit and watch.
At the end of this road, Narinder Bengal's farm. He took a boat in and peered into the windows of his home.
All the furniture floating. All the shoes floating. Cars under the water. All my nurseries. Oh, everything's under the water.
Everyone we spoke with today has long-term solutions to prevent this kind of flooding in mind, like beefing up the Barrowtown pumping station. But for now, all eyes are on Tuesday and what that might bring. Katie Nicholson, CBC News, Abbotsford.